Welcome. I'm Landon Doss. I'm 19 years old and I make six figures a year. I do cybersecurity. I'm like the James Bond, and I also have two businesses that I operate online. Now, in today's video, I'm going to show you how I was able to scale my home renovation business up to about $30,000 a month in revenue. So, and today I'm going to go over a step-by-step guide on how to make a home renovation business. So, let's start with the first thing. We have home renovation. These are the pros and cons of home renovation. So we have it pays good. You make $10,000 a month of profit, but the downside is it is hard ass work. You're gonna break your back. It's just hard. Another pro is it's easy to scale quick. You can make $10,000 by like your fourth or fifth month. Probably third through fifth month, you can make 10 grand. But it's long ass days. You have to be willing to put in the work because this stuff, I'm saying long days. Have to put in the work. So it's easy to learn, but the equipment costs a lot. I'm going to show you guys later in the video how to like save up for equipment, things like that. Next one is it makes you good at sales, but you have to be a people person. Now not everyone's a people person, but I truly believe everyone can act like they're a people person. If you see what I'm saying, you have to learn it. If you want to be an entrepreneur, you want to be in sales, you want to be in this type of thing, you have to learn how to be a people person. Throw on a face, be an actor. I like me. I'm an actor. When I'm doing my sales and things like that, I am never the type to be like, "Oh, hey, bro, what's going on?" Now, in public and stuff, I do that all the time, but I'm stepping out of my comfort zone. So I wouldn't say it's acting. It's just being a good person, stepping out of your comfort zone. So I wouldn't call that acting because when I go and I network with people, it's not acting to try and sell. It's just stepping into, that different side of you. So now we're going to talk about the timeline of it. So we have phase one, so it's currently February right now. I just put February because we're already in there. So the first thing is phase one. This is the launch prep. And I'm gonna go over everything in this video. It's probably gonna be a little bit of a long video, but I'm gonna go over everything step by step. So we have phase one, launch prep. Phase two is marketing, and phase three is working. So launch prep is probably gonna be about a month long, but the phase two and phase three is going to last the whole business, okay? Because you're always marketing and you're always working. So now I have your first $10,000 a month, probably around, what is this, a third month, probably around 3 to 5 months, you probably have your first $10,000 a month of profit if you are willing to work, if you put in the hours. And then we have keep growing. So keep growing, keep scaling your business, hire some people, things like that. Now, the next thing we're going to talk about is what services you offer. Now is when we get into the detail and the goods. So home renovation. This is what I did. I did pressure washing. Now, pressure washing homes, pressure washing sidewalks, pressure washing driveways, pressure washing mailboxes, all of these things. Now, pressure washer is expensive. You can go to Lowe's, you can probably get one for $500, $600, but you have to scale up there, right? So you can't just go and buy a $600 pressure washer if you don't have $600 to buy one. So we're gonna start from the bottom and work our way up to get all the good equipment. So that's pressure washing. That's what I did. The next thing I did was landscaping. Landscaping, that's trimming trees, trimming bushes, resodding yards. Like I would resod yards. We'd have a truck come in, drop the sod off for us, and then we just sod the whole yard. We'd also get a tiller, till all the old sod up, so rake it, boom, 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 put new sod down. We did everything. Now, the next one I did was flooring. Now, flooring, people say, oh, it's easy. It's not easy. There's a difference between professionals and amateurs doing flooring. I was a professional. I was really good at doing flooring. Now, someone will come in and say, "Bro, I did flooring with my dad and it was easy." That's because your dad did all the cuts. If you would be a professional at doing flooring, watch a ton of YouTube videos and truly understand how to do it, because when you're trying to like cut around a wall, it's all math. It's all math. So if you want to do flooring, you have to be good at math. And because when you're trying to cut around a wall, like say there's a wall here and or a toilet or something like that, it's very hard, especially with closets, toilets, things like that. You have to be able to do the math and the calculations to calculate, okay, so the toilet's gonna go here. Okay, so I need the floor to be here. Okay, the wall's off a little bit, because with some of these homes, older homes, things like that, they're replacing the flooring. Now, with older homes, the walls might be a little warped. So you're gonna have to cut that laminate or the hardwood, whatever you're cutting. You're gonna have to cut it at like an angle. Maybe the wall is warped here. So you're gonna have to cut around the wall. So flooring is a hard skill to learn. So you have to be a professional if you really wanna scale your business. So you have to just learn it. All right. So the next thing we're talking about is painting. Now, a lot of people say painting's easy, and painting is easy if you're an amateur. But if you're a professional, you have to be really good at it. Now, there's a difference between the amateur and professional. An amateur is going to leave streaks, he's going to leave lines on the wall, he's going to leave the marks. A professional wouldn't. Now, anyone can go in and paint their own home, right? Anyone can do that. Why would someone not just go in and paint their own home? Take them a day or day, you know, 2 weeks, a week, whatever, depending on the size of the room or if they're painting their whole home. Why would they not? Because they're amateurs. Now, you want to be a professional. You have to go in and not leave streaks because they can go in and paint their walls, but you'll see like streaks on their walls. You know, you'll see roll marks from where they rolled the wall. So if you want to be a good painter, you want to scale your business, you have to be really good at painting, right? And when you're doing cuts, say like here's cuts right here. So right here is called baseboards. You can't really see it. But when you're cutting along the line of a baseboard, you don't want the paint to drip on the baseboard. So you can do painter's tape, things like that. Now, I'm not gonna teach you guys how to paint in this video. Maybe that's the time for another one. Now, the next thing we're gonna talk about is junk removal. Anyone can do this. It's very, very easy. Junk removal. As long as you're 16, you get yourself a little beat up truck, you know, $2,000, $3,000 truck, you can go now and do junk removal. So junk removal is basically just when people have shit. Say they just removed some hardwood or tile, or they have a bunch of shit in their garage they won't remove, or stuff by the road, whatever. You just go in, you throw it in your truck and or your trailer, whatever, and then you take it to the dump and you charge them money. That's the basic concept of junk removal. Now we have tree and bush trimming. So this is along the lines of landscaping, but when I said landscaping, I was meaning sod replacement, things like this. But tree and bush trimming, this is a skill set that you have to master because I remember when I first started my business. 2 or 3 years ago, I was really bad at it. And the guy was like, "Hey man, you got to fix this." And he really taught me because me and my buddy did the job. And he's like, "Hey, if I posted a picture of this on Nextdoor, Nextdoor is a marketing tactic I'm going to teach you guys. On Nextdoor, would you think you would get good reviews?" And I looked at it and I was like, "Oh shit." I was like, "No, I don't think I would." And then he really straightened me up. He was a businessman and he really taught me a lot. He was a good mentor for a little bit. Now we have lawn care. I would never do lawn care because I don't think it's a good return on your time investment. Now, you could do lawn care if you're a young kid, you know, your neighbor's yard or things like that. Totally normal. Do your lawn care. That way you can scale up to buy bigger things, like buy a pressure washer, buy a truck for junk removal, buy these things. Now, with lawn care, the reason I don't think it's a good like time on your return investment is because if you can only charge $100 a month for a biweekly, that's $50 a mow, if you can only charge that, it's not worth your time unless you have a ton of clients. And if you do have a ton of clients, it was still wouldn't be worth it. Only $50 a mow, $50 for you to load your truck up, load your trailer up, load your weed eater, load your all that shit, load your whatever, load your stuff, and then go drive 20 minutes to their house, mow it for an hour and a half, whatever, and then load your stuff back up, go back home. That just took you 2 or 3 hours for $50. That is not worth it. With pressure washing, you can make $100 an hour. With flooring, you can make $100 an hour. With painting, you can make $100 an hour. All this stuff, you can make hundreds of like $100 an hour. Now, with lawn care, you fucking can't. It's so hard unless you're charging like $200, $300 a month. But who's gonna really pay for that unless you are an extremely good person at lawn care? No one. So unless you're a really good lawn care company that's established and known, no one's gonna pay a teenager freaking $400, $300 a month to mow their yard. So, which one are you gonna do? You have to pick the ones you would do. So, now we're gonna go on to phase one. This is called the launch phase. So, first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna establish our offer right here. What are you gonna do? So, we're gonna come back here. What are you gonna do? If I was a kid or a young man and I didn't have enough money or I didn't have the skill set for flooring and painting, the first thing I would do was I would start landscaping. So, this is what I would do to earn income. To buy more expensive things like equipment and costs and things like that. What I would do is I would go and I would grab a rake. Rake, Walmart, $20, whatever. Go grab a rake. And then go door knocking, door-to-door sales. Best marketing tactic, especially when you're trying to like come up and just start your business. Door-to-door sales is literally the best. So knock, "Hey sir, can I rake your yard for $50?" "Oh, sure." Boom, 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 rake. "Hey, next house." Boom, knock. "Hey, can I rake your yard for $50?" And just do this for as many yards as you can. And then you start to scale up your business. Now you have the capital to go buy a pressure washer. Now you have the capital after doing, you know, five, six, seven, eight pressure washing jobs to go get your truck. Now you have a truck to go and do our price washing jobs, to do the junk removal, to do all these things. Now that is how you scale it. You start small. You just start with a little rake. $20 rake just made you thousands of dollars because you were able to scale it. Now you have to learn painting flooring. Get your mom, try the stuff on your own house, whatever. Mom, please let me do flooring in the house or whatever. You don't even have to do it. Go to your driveway, get you a box of flooring from Lowe's, a couple bucks. Learn how to do it. You can use a razor blade to snap laminate. You can use a jigsaw to cut, but jigsaw is expensive. So like I said, you have to just scale this stuff. Now, I'm not going to teach you guys in this video how to, you know, paint, how to do flooring, things like that. There's so many videos online on how to do that. Or you can just get a course on like all that shit, because there's so much stuff out there for you guys to learn. So next thing we're going to do is we're going to start a website. Starting a website is the best thing for your business. And how you can start a website is you can do like, just look up online website builders. And there's so many. And pretty much every single one that's going to come up is very good. So after you make your website, you're going to print out flyers or cards, business cards and flyers. You go to VistaPrint. And what you want to do on it is you want to establish a story and you want your phone number and your website on there. So, and establish what you do. So for example, mine were like my phone number and our website, and the name of my business. So name of the business on the top, then below is like your story. So we all do a story. Like for example, my dad wasn't involved in my business, but I just wanted that as like a fallback point. Like to build comfort with people, because I was young, you know, I was 16, 17, 18 year old kid. No one's going to really trust me to redo their whole home, to renovate their home. But if I put on the flyer, me and my dad started this business to help our community, blah, 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 blah. And when I would go on these like estimates, my dad was such an amazing dad that he would go on the estimates with me, on the bids with me. So what is an estimate and what is a bid? A bid is when you go, like you get a call, and they say, hey, can you come check out my job? I want flooring done, or I want some trees trimmed or something. If it was a big job like flooring or painting or some shit, I was renovating homes, I would always go and get my dad to help me. I would say, hey, dad, can you come with me? Because my dad, he knew a lot about home renovations, so he could talk the language. So I would get him to come with me and we would both introduce ourselves, things like that. So now they get a comfort feeling. Oh, okay, this young kid and his father. Okay, so his father's going to watch over him and they're going to both do a great job on my house, blah, blah, blah. But then I would just show up to the house. On time of work, I would just show up to the house and I'd be good. Boom. Like it was just being me. I'm not, where's his dad at? Blah, blah, blah. But it was just being me renovating because I already closed the deal. What are they going to say? Hey, where's your dad? I'm like, oh yeah, he can't work today, blah, blah, blah. But I'm going to get this job done. I'm like, do a really good job for you. Oh, okay. And then I blow their mind with the work I do because I'm really good at renovating homes because I have so much experience that I just did an amazing job. And now, you know, they're happy, all that stuff. But I would never got the job in the first place if my amazing dad didn't come with me to help bid it, right? So that's just a helpful tip. If you're a young kid and you have a good dad, do that because it is very helpful to, you know, land jobs. So like I said, write, establish your story of what you're going to do and the website on the bottom, phone number, blah, 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 blah. And what you guys do. So for example, you can say, me and my father started this business because we really want to help our community. We do X, Y, Z. We do landscaping, home renovations, blah, 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 blah. Things like that. You want a story to touch people's hearts, to make them feel like, oh, okay, nice. Hell yeah. Okay. Him and his dad, all that's so cute. They're a great freaking family, whatever. So do that. You establish that on your flyers. And then business cards are different. So your business card, this is a food wrapper, but a business card is like this. You know a business card. A flyer is like one of those little door hangers, right? So when I say flyer, I mean door hanger. They have like the little hook at the top and then they're like a flyer like this. And you can just walk and you hang on people's doors. So that is the launch phase. That is what you need to do to have everything ready. Website, flyers and business cards. And you can even make t-shirts as well. I had t-shirts that said Dolls Home Renovations on them. So that's the launch phase. Now we're moving into phase two. Phase two is the marketing. This is the best way to do it. So we have door to door. This is the best way. If you want to like establish your business and scale it as fast as you can, door to door sales is the best way, I promise you. Because you're able to build that connection with people and everyone's a lead. If you don't know what a lead is just someone that you're potentially doing business with. So if you get a phone call from someone, that's a lead. Now, if you go up to a door and you knock on their door, they're a homeowner. They need stuff done, especially if you look at their yard and their bushes are out of whack, their trees suck, their landscaping sucks, all the stuff sucks, their roof is like ran down, they look like it's a bad house. You have a service to offer them. So they're a lead. They have a bad yard. They need your help. And the number one thing in business and in this stuff is you have to truly believe that people need it. Like you have to be like, oh, dude, I can actually help them. You have to be willing to help people. And people can tell that. People can tell the difference. If you go to up to a door-to-door sale and you're trying to sell on someone and you're like, hey, yes, sir, blah, blah, hey, I saw you need some stuff. Or if you're passionate about it and you love this shit, people can see that. And they're way more likely to do business with you if you're passionate about it and you really want to help them. And you have to believe in your service and believe in your product. You have to believe that this service is the best service around and no one can beat you. That is the best way to do door-to-door sales. And when you do door-to-door sales, knock every single fucking door. Now, it is hard. So with social anxiety, if you are like uncomfortable, it does take some time getting used to it. But the best way to get used to it as fast as you can is wear sunglasses and a hat. It almost masks you. You don't really know who you are, and you feel like more incognito. So it helps with social anxiety to wear sunglasses and a hat when you're knocking doors, things like that. And if you're too afraid to knock doors, especially when I was younger, I was too afraid to knock doors. I still did it anyways, but in some houses, if I heard like a dog barking or something, I would just hang the flyer up on their door and then walk away. Because you're still, I've actually had this happen. I've had two or three calls being like, hey, I saw your flyer on my door. Can you come check this out? And I'm like, okay, yeah, come check it out now. So door-to-door sales is one of the best. The next one is word of mouth. Word of mouth is a really good way to sell. And that's why it's very important to do a great job on people's homes because you need word of mouth. If you go to and do a job, do a bid or something like that, and they're like, hey, yeah, man, this kid was great. This young man, he was very professional, amazing. I would definitely work with him a day again. He had great landscaping skills. He trimmed my bush real nice. Pause. He trimmed my bush real nice. They're gonna go and tell people, and people, oh, he did a great job for you. Oh, okay, yeah, I'll check him out. Yeah, let's see what he's about. Everyone's gonna want to work with you if everyone's spreading your name about how fucking amazing you are. So word of mouth is very important. That's why it's very important to do a good job on these people's homes. You can't just go and be like a young dickhead and be like, hey, yeah, here, yeah, whatever, and rake their yard and leave leaves in it, because then you're not going to have a good word of mouth. People are going to say, nah, that kid was trash. I would never use his business again. So don't do like a shit job. Make sure you're doing amazing jobs for these people. The next one is Facebook ads. Facebook ads, I would always delegate about 20% of my income to Facebook ads. So for example, if I made a thousand, like for if I did a job and it was a $1,000 job, or let's say 1200 for easy math, it was a $1,200 job. I spent $200 in material, so that brings my net profit down to $1,000. And I would take 20% of that and I would put it in Facebook ads. So now I would take $200 and put it in Facebook ads. So now Facebook ads running, marketing my business, and I'm getting leads on Facebook. Now, the best one that has worked, or one of the best ones, these three, word of mouth, door to door, and next door, are literally the best ones ever. Like these are all S tier, A tier, whatever you want to call it. So next door has gotten me so many jobs. Now, next door is like a it's like an Instagram app for old people, like neighbors, things like that. It's a bunch of old folks that do it, but it's like Instagram, but for like neighbors. It's literally amazing, especially for your business. Now, the key to Nextdoor is after you go and do a job, you have to get them to review your service on Nextdoor or to make a post about you on Nextdoor. That's the best way because if they make a post about you on Nextdoor, say, hey, yeah, this young man, he just went and trimmed my bush and it was a fucking amazing. He trimmed the shit out of my bush. Then, pause. Then they're going to, like, probably 100 people will see that. Everyone in your neighborhood is going to see that. Everyone in your city is going to see it and they're like, oh, that kid does an amazing job. Oh, yeah, what's his phone number? Or what's his website? Whatever, whatever. And now you're going to get a ton of leads. So it's kind of like a word of mouth, but through social media. So I always ask people to review your service on Nextdoor because so many people, like every old person has Nextdoor. So always get someone to review your service on Nextdoor. It is the best. Now, what we're going to cover now is your priorities. So we have do it now, do it next, if there's time, and don't do it. Do it now. We have active jobs and bids. Do it now. And replying to customers. These are the main three things. You need to do this stuff now. Now, if you're working on a job, if you're going to do a bid, like I said, a bid is like a lead. A bid is when you go out to a job and you bid the job. So you say, hey, sir, yeah, what do you need done? They say, I need this, this, this. And then you bid it. You give them a price for it. Replying to customers, being good customer service. Do all this stuff now. Now we have to do it next. After this stuff is covered, your active jobs, your biz, replying to customers, this is what you want to do next. So if you don't have anything else to do this stuff. Door-to-door sales and Facebook ads, the marketing. The marketing is what you want to do next. Next thing is if there's time. So if you already did door-to-door sales for the day, you come home, it's nighttime, you have nothing else to do, work on your website to perfect it, work on the copywriting for the flyers. That means like the storytelling, making sure the grammar's correct, all this stuff, and tell people about your work. If you're at the gym or whatever, go to the gym. Tell people, hey, yeah, I just started a landscaping business. Hey, I just started a home renovation business. Yeah, tell everyone about your work. If you meet someone in Walmart, that's why it's so important to network. Networking was one of the best things. I talk to everyone. Go to Walmart, say, hey, sir, how are you doing? Yeah, how are you doing? They're, oh, yeah, oh, nice to meet you. Go to the gym, tell people, tell everyone about your stuff. And like I said, work on the website, work on your copywriting on the website, make sure you have a good website, make sure it tells a story, make sure all the stuff. Now, don't do it ever. Stop jerking off to Pornhub. You're being cucked by it. If you watch your dream girl getting fucked, that is cuck. So are you a cuck? No, you're not a cuck. So stop jerking off to Pornhub. Stop edging to girls while snapping them. You're wasting time. I know when I was younger, dude, this is a common thing every man does. So don't think you're different if you don't do it, because I know you do it. You sit there and you edge for 2 or 3 hours at night while snapping chase. Every man does it. So every man knows what I'm talking about. So don't do it. It's a huge time waster. When I cut out all these things, that's when life really took off for me. You cut out snapping girls, edging. You stop playing video games all the time because video games, all this stuff waste time. And you stop smoking weed. Now, I smoke cigarettes, yes, and I get a lot of hate for it, but I don't really want to quit right now. I know it's bad for me, but the difference between weed and cigarettes is weed makes you slow. You are going to be content with your life if you're always high. If you're always high, you're never living in the real world, so you're just going to like always think like, oh yeah, life is good, life is good, when you're living in a shit life. So stop smoking weed, it's wasting your time, and it makes you like okay with your reality if your reality sucks. Stop playing video games because again, it distracts you long enough to give you a little bit of dopamine and to make you forget about your shit life, your situation. So stop playing video games. Stop edging at girls while snapping. It's a waste of time, and it's just the instant gratification, the snapping. And stop jerking off to Pornhub because it's like I said again, it's all instant gratification. So I hope you guys got a lot of value from this video. If you want more, there's literally 2 hours of me talking about it inside Fitness University. I give you guys way more in depth of this video. This video was just to give the people the basics of it. This will give you a great baseline to know what to do. And after this video, you have already learned everything you need to know, right? You should be able to go now and start your business and kill shit. You should be able to buy in 2 or 3 months. You should be making around $2,000 to $5,000 a month. And if you're not, that is all your fault for not doing like everything I said in this video. Because if you work 14, 15, 16 hours a day, I promise you, you can't fail. God plus work equals success 100% of the time. But yeah, like I said, there's also a free school I made called, what is it called? Fitness Academy. I just want a bunch of like-minded men in there. It's literally completely free. I just want to be around like-minded men like myself and everyone on the mission to get better and be the best version of themselves, make money, do fitness, all this stuff. So Fitness Academy is free. Fitness University is my paid community. All the links will be in the description of this video. But yeah, I just want to give you guys this video to help every young man out there if they want to, change their lives or start your own business. This is the best business to start, especially when you're a young man, because you literally can't fail. So thank you guys for watching. I'll see you guys in the next video.